do not like this. I do not like this one bit. I know I can make this work. If you can hear the sound of my voice, maybe you can help us. We're at the sorority house on Forest Street, and we need help from a killer. Please!
If there are any officers in the area, a man with a knife is reportedly attacking the inhabitants of the sorority house on Forest Street. We'll be on site in minutes.
Your job is to serve and protect, so get out to Omega, Sigma, Theta, and protect us from this freak trying to kill us all!
in the area reports the emergency from Beta Sorority House on Forest. An intruder is on the front.
Citizens are in an uproar demanding answers from Texas state officials on why no arrests have been made in the case. Reports say an unidentified man entered the home in the middle of the night, viciously strangling one female to death before attempting to stab both roommates who were sleeping nearby. Authorities believe the attacker fled the scene after discovering multiple people lived in the house. The man is believed to be in his late 20s, has dark hair and brown eyes, and has several scars on his face and arms. Police are urging anyone.
Come on, I gotta do something. I can't die here. So easily here. Careful. I can get through here. Actually use. Pay attention. Thank you. got this. Do I get out of here? I got this.
down here now! You're moving!
That's what you get.
In 1967 for aggravated assault and larceny, and was sentenced to 5 years in prison. After his release, Omar Pauly was implicated in a string of incidents outside McLennan County, where he was arrested again but managed to escape authorities. His current whereabouts are unknown. New details have emerged in the grisly string of murders that littered Interstate 40 during 1971 and 72, known only as the Terror of I-40. Authorities say it's unidentified.